Welcome back to the 44th Design Automation Conference here in San Diego, California. I'm Brian Fuller, Editor-in-Chief of EE Times. And we've stolen away Magma CEO Rajeev Madhavan for a few minutes from his bustling booth here on the floor. Rajeev, your company, even before you settled the litigation with Synopsys, stock was doing a nice little uptick there. And you guys, from what I can tell, have outperformed the industry in the last 6 months or so. What gives?
I think there are a couple of things, right? I mean, the stock started moving. It was very much depressed because of litigation. I mean, litigation took it to a point where anything good or bad the company did was not really going to have an impact. So we actually invested heavily in R&D. Stock started moving up when one or two of the good verdicts came along our way, the IBM thing. And then when it settled, it started going up. Now the street is beginning to actually listen to us as a company rather than us as under the cloud cover. So we have an opportunity of delivering, and we have a lot of new tools that are coming out from us. We've started with an analog simulator that we launched 12 months ago, and we have steadily increased the amount of tools that we've come out with, right? FindSim is by far the fastest growing product we have had in the history of the company. So we have a bunch of product lines which are coming along, and we have said this, we are committed to delivering full solutions for analog, RF, and mixed signal design. So Street is beginning to reward us for what risk we took when we were under the cloud of litigation. So it's a good period for us. It's a good period where we continue to invest and sort of reap the rewards of that investment we've done.
A lot of people are trying to expand the pie, and you know, by that might mean, you know, out of the traditional engineering market that it's gone after. How does this industry grow in your...
So I think the last year actually was a good year for EDA, in my view, because the reasons are very... the industry did grow a healthy 10%. Wall Street didn't care about us because, the industry is a little bit of a bitter industry in terms of taking market share from one to the other, litigating each other. All of that we have to put behind us now. Look and have a very succinct and clear message to the outside Wall Street. We need to fix that. I think if we had fixed that itself, we would have gone a little bit bigger in terms of our valuations and on Wall Street. Second thing we need to do is, as an industry, we're now not, and that accounts for not very many small IPOs happening. Our customers are dealt with the problem of having to increase the engineering workforce to do these semiconductor chips. I mean, so the amount of people putting on one piece of silicon has escalated significantly. And that is not a productive terms for them, because they really cannot put a lot of silicon design activity underway if the cost of each silicon has exploded. So we as an industry are just beginning to accept that reality and provide solutions in that. And that means more and more about providing solutions and automations. And that in and of itself means a lot of startups who are doing some technologies in one piece will end up getting more and more assimilated into one of these providers of solutions rather than trying to go public.
Right.
So, I mean, I have this thing which basically my viewpoint is categories create companies, right? Placement route created Cadence in the first year, right? And synthesis created Synopsys. Physical synthesis created Magma.
Right.
And features gets acquired. And that's becoming very clear. I mean, even if you look at the class of 2001 of everybody who went out, everyone was, except Magma, we created a category. Everyone else was like creating a feature and verification where it got acquired, right? Test bench. And that is a generically happening at a global level today. And some of those acquisitions are happening earlier, and some of it is being done in-house by companies like us, right? We are basically saying if we can do it ourselves, we should attempt to do that, and we should make that technology happen here. So industry has been inwardly bound. We have to get externally bound to our customers, externally bound to Wall Street a lot more.
So the hot rumor of the week that was reported in the New York Times is that private equity is looking at Cadence.
Yeah.
What's your take on the impact of private equity coming into this industry if it comes to pass?
See, I think, you know, anytime there's a private equity transaction, people do it with some, hopefully they're doing it with some end goal in mind, right? I mean, when you take it private, you have to finance a debt to make some kind of transactions happen. Now, I specifically don't want to comment on the Cadence transaction as a public company. We really don't want to do that. But I think, you know, as long as people are thinking about it from a long-term exit plan, private equity may have some value in adding in making some changes and transitions that any one of these companies wants to do.
You were on a panel the other day,
yeah.
and you talked about that, and you said,
yeah.
You know, basically, you don't necessarily have to go IPO.
Well,
and so knowing what you know now, knowing if you could have anticipated Sarbanes-Oxley and all kinds of stuff like that, would you have taken Magma public?
So the question is this, right? If the goal was, and if Magma didn't see a path to $178 million, and our goal is very clear, we want to be a $500 million company by a particular year, and we have that target. So 2010, you know, we need to achieve that levels of targets. We internally have those targeted, focused numbers that we need to achieve. If I don't see a path to that, and I did not see that, if I did not see that in 2001, it would have been premature and idiotic for us to go public.
Right.
So you have to see that. But if you're in a category, like say you're doing circuit simulation, there was a company, NASDAQ, and NASDAQ went public at that time, right? How big is that market? $250 million? So you could grow to taking, you know, maximum is $200 million.
Yeah.
So you have to ask that question as an entrepreneur. I'm in a space which has got a total available market of this. Am I going to scale? How do I scale? So we had that vision. We had that wherewithal. And we had the management talent within the company to do that. Myself and Roy were wanting to build that. And we were, you know, putting our life to do that. And that was what is essential to doing that.
Last question. Let's talk about DAC as a show. This is the 44th DAC. And while yesterday looked pretty grim, today the traffic seems to be back up. The final numbers won't be in for a while. But year after year, it just seems to be sort of eroding at least the exhibit floor as a successful place for you guys to meet customers. What's the future of this show?
So I think, you know, the exhibit floor for us, as you see, one of the comments that people were making is we have increased because we have gotten new tools. But if you don't have new tools, it's tough. And even if you have new tools, the fact is you're talking to the customers already in terms of when the size of silicon design has gone up, there's only very fewer players who are doing the bigger chips mm-hmm. right now. Right? So we are in dialogue with the customers. That sort of degrades the value of a show like DAC to a certain degree. But however, I think, you know, given that DAC and design and manufacturing and all these things are coming together, it may be wise for something like DAC to combine and closer to SemiCon or be next to SemiCon or something like that. I think, in order to stop erosion, we need to show where we can integrate with other people in a much more automation fashion. So I think it's time for DAC to look at those options. So do we want to actually go and combine ourselves with other shows? I think it would help a lot of EDO vendors here.
Yeah.
If we get a more amount of audience of wants to see that combinations, it's happening technically.
Yeah.
Might as well make it happen from a business perspective here as well. So I look forward to the committees always looking at those kind of options. It's tough because, you know, you're combining with a bigger conference. But I think we have to make some tough decisions in making these conferences more prone to getting more users from different places attend and see that integration values as we are forced to deliver from a technology perspective in that way anyhow.
Yeah. Well, yeah, who would have predicted that there wouldn't be a Comdex 15 years ago, right?
Yeah,
when
yeah.
I was on the growth path. Anyway, Rajeev Madhavan, CEO of Magma, has been kind enough to chat with us here on the show floor.
Thank
Rajeev,
you.
Rajeev, have a good rest of the show.
Thank you, Ryan. Good seeing you.
Good seeing you.